Welcome back, everyone. I'm Jordan Giesecke, and this is The Limiting Factor. Today, we're going to be talking about Shirley Meng from the University of California, San Diego. Shirley's lab specializes in developing the materials we need to create low-cost, high-performance batteries. These batteries will open the door to technologies such as truly long-range affordable vehicles and electric jets. This is our battery playground. This is where we are now. This is Shirley's current target, and this is where her research will eventually take us. So, let's take a look at Shirley and her lab, her focus, findings, and what those findings could mean for battery technology in the next 3 years and beyond. Shirley Meng is a professor of nano-engineering and the lead investigator at UC San Diego's Battery Laboratory. Since gaining her PhD in 2005, she quickly became a key player in battery research by founding the Sustainable Power and Energy Center. She's also taken on multiple reviewer and editor positions, and is a fellow of the Electrochemical Society. Finally, the kicker is that she is mentored and advised by two titans in the battery research field, Stanley Whittingham and John Goodenough, who both received a Nobel Prize for their work on inventing the lithium-ion battery. Shirley set up the Sustainable Power and Energy Center to solve the battery problem in a multidisciplinary way. Building a better battery is one of the most difficult and pressing problems in science today, and her lab uses theoretical, computational, and experimental approaches to solve that problem. Scientists have only recently invented the tools we need to look inside of a battery cell to see how it works, and the artificial intelligence needed to predict which battery materials will work instead of spending decades taking educated guesses. The technologies used to look into a cell are called advanced characterization. The tools used to predict battery materials are called modeling. By using advanced characterization and modeling, Shirley's team is beginning to solve problems that have been frustrating the industry for decades. Before Shirley came along, the battery was a black box, and thanks to her, we now have a better understanding of what's going on in batteries and how to build them better. Let's take a look at two examples of characterization. Here we can see some phenomenal X-ray imaging of particles moving back and forth as a battery charges and discharges. As you can see, the flow of particles back and forth is uneven and there are hotspots. These hotspots may lead to inefficiencies and faults. Now that scientists can actually see what's going on, they can work out how to make the batteries more consistent and diagnose failure mechanisms. From here, they can take this a step further and zoom in on an individual particle to see how the defects in the material change as it charges and discharges. This slide shows that zoom-in capability. This is an X-ray image of individual metallic nanoparticles within the battery. These particles hold and transfer energy to make the battery work. The green asteroid-shaped objects are images of the particles, and the rainbow-colored images are measuring the internal structure of the particles to show stresses. What Shirley's team found in this study is that as a battery charges and discharges, the crystals deform and develop weaknesses. In other words, the crystals are breaking apart, which, of course, degrades the battery. Now that we know this and can measure it, we can engineer batteries that reduce this degradation. In both of these characterization examples, the tools are helping scientists to understand the first principles of how batteries actually work. Armed with that knowledge, they can push the envelope of technology. Let's take a look at an example of modeling. When Shirley was at MIT, she helped work on a materials database seen here. And what you see is hundreds of data points derived by gathering the electrochemical and physical properties of known materials, and then applying algorithms to predict how those materials would perform. Here is a technical chart of how this process works. Yeah, I'm not going to go that deep. On this chart, the farther to the right and the higher up the battery is, the more energy the battery can store. This database is part of what's called the battery materials genome. Because, like a living organism, certain groups of chemicals have common characteristics. As you can see, the materials genome narrowed down the search from hundreds or thousands of options to half a dozen, all of which happen to be in the genome of oxides, or chemicals that contain oxygen. What the chart is telling us is that these compounds store a large amount of amp hours at high voltage, meaning there is a lot of stored energy. A good analogy for this would be a water tower that stores a large amount of water at high pressure. The modeling can also be used to predict new properties, guide synthesis, and bring new battery chemistries from lab to market in 8 years. The standard is 15 to 20 years. If you combine the work Jeff Don is doing, which was discussed in my last video, with Shirley's work, the next 10 years will see us step into a new age of energy. Between the two of them, they are pulling us out of the dark ages by eliminating trial and error and saving us decades of throwing spaghetti at the wall to see what sticks. There's one last thing I want to call out here, which Shirley has mentioned several times. This was in 2017, and she's calling for a 500 watt-hour a kg battery chemistry to be discovered by 2022.
In the next 5 years, please expect some very exciting news coming out from the Battery 500 Consortium.
Here's a post from her Twitter account only a few days ago. Happy New Year, particularly for all of us who are working on solving the world's energy challenges. 2020 will be a big year for us all. Shirley has worked with Maxwell Technology, a Tesla acquisition. Tesla will be doing a battery investor day on this technology in the next few months. I think she's teasing us. I'll be talking about this in greater depth in a future video. In my next video, I'm going to try my hand at designing a supersonic vertical takeoff and landing electric jet. I've seen a few designs out there, but I have my own view on how I think it'll look, and more importantly, why I think it'll look that way. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe below. I'm also starting a Patreon. You'll find the details of that in the description. That's all for the day. Thanks for tuning in.